A region of space-time where gravity is so strong that no particles, not even electromagnetic radiation, can escape from. In 2019, the groundbreaking results of the Event Horizon Telescope were published. In this three-episode event, we are hunting the biggest secrets of space. This is the hunt for black and white holes. The concept of a black hole was first proposed in 1783 by a geologist named John Michael, as a body does not allow light to escape due to its very strong gravitational field. According to Michael's calculations, a body with a radius of the Sun and a density of 500 times will have an escape velocity faster than the speed of light at its surface and will therefore be invisible. A first solution of general relativity that would characterize a black hole was found by Karl Schwarzschild in 1916. Only 50 years later, in 1967, John Wheeler first used the term black hole. Anything that falls into the black hole is pulled to a point in the center of the black hole with an unknown fate. The mass of a black hole is so big that we have to express it in sun masses. A sun mass, 1m, is equal to the mass of our sun. Our sun mass is 1.99 quintillion kilograms. A quintillion is a 1 with 10 zeros and corresponds to approximately 332,946 times the mass of the Earth. In the life cycle of stars, stars with low or medium masses spend the final stages of their lives as red giants and turning into white dwarfs. When massive stars explode, they live the rest of their star life as a neutron star or black hole. The existence of black holes is theoretically predicted in Einstein's general relativity as a mass compact enough to cause deformation and curvature in space-time. Event horizon, the name of the boundary region where nothing can escape from, has also enormous effects on the fate of an object crossing it. The event horizon is almost spherical with a Schwarzschild radius around the center point of the black hole. This sphere is an area of space-time through which light and matter can pass in only one direction, inwards. As soon as you enter the sphere, you will be doomed to approach the center of the black hole without stopping and you will never return. Light that passes near a black hole passes along a curved path if it does not reach the event horizon. However, if light reaches the event horizon, it falls into the black hole and no information can escape. The materials and gases around the black hole rotate in a circular orbit around the black hole. This is the so-called accretion disk. This rotation causes heat and radiation. The more massive the black hole, the larger the size of the accretion disk. The accretion disk can expand up to 3 times the Schwarzschild radius. The mass growth of massive black holes can be seen through the accretion disk as the active nuclei of galaxies or quasars. In the massive black holes, jets of material such as high-velocity electrons are being ejected perpendicular to the disk surface and out of the center on either side. These jets are also a source of strong radio waves. Black holes occur in a variety of processes, which can be classified in 3 classes. Black holes formed by the collapse of stars, black holes formed by collision processes, and black holes formed by the density of heterogeneities in the early universe. When the evolution of a massive star ends, he can collapse and form a black hole. The stars with a mass larger than 8 times the mass of the Sun change to a black hole at the end of their life. In fact, a typical star is stable for a long time, at which the burning of hydrogen provides the thermal pressure to withstand gravity. During nuclear interactions and collisions between atoms, hydrogen is converted to helium. Light and heat are generated as a result of these. Radiation pressure neutralizes the force of gravity. In mass nuclei larger than 5 times the mass of the Sun, and after the hydrogen fuel is depleted and most of it is converted to helium, the helium begins to burn and carbon atoms are produced. In the core of a massive star, carbon can burn at a temperature of about 600 million degrees Kelvin. The burning of carbon produces oxygen, neon, sodium and magnesium. The oxygen burning reaction occurs at a temperature of about 1 billion Kelvin. Finally, after burning carbon and oxygen, the nucleus is a combination of the element silicon. At temperatures close to 3 billion Kelvin, silicon starts to burn. Combustion of silicon in the nucleus produces iron. Any reaction that produces nuclei heavier than iron is thermophilic and cannot contribute to the luminosity of the star. At this point, the star looks like a layered onion. Except for the core, all the layers are burning. For a star with a mass 20 times the mass of our Sun, it takes 10 million years to burn its helium nucleus, but the burning of oxygen takes about 200 days and the silicon burns out in 2 days. Finally, when the nucleus is filled with iron in the plasma state, fusion no longer continues, so the gravity that creates the inward pressure is greater than the outward radiative pressure, and eventually the star collapses as a result of the dominance of its gravitational force and a supernova explosion occurs. If the remains of the star's core are about a mass of 1.4 to 3 times the mass of the Sun, a neutron star is born. If the mass exceeds more than 3 times the mass of the Sun, he turns into a black hole. Black holes that are formed by collision processes have been investigated by the Indian physicist Subramanian Chandrasekhar. He calculated that a compact body of degenerate matter, such as a white dwarf, is not stable enough if its mass exceeded 1.44 times the mass of the Sun. The white dwarf collapsed into a neutron star. And also, in a binary system of neutron stars and ordinary stars, a neutron star can absorb mass from its companion star and change to a black hole. Another category of black holes is primordial black holes. They are the remnants of the beginning of the universe and were composed of matter density disorders. In the early universe, everything was in thermal equilibrium and high temperatures and pressure prevailed over the universe. As a result of disturbances in the density of matter, a very high density resulted in the collapse of different regions and formed the first black hole. Primordial black holes can have a variety of masses, depending on when they formed. Different models of the early universe differ in the size they predict the heterogeneities responsible for the formation of a black hole. These models predict the mass of the first black holes in a wide range, from a Planck unit to hundreds of thousands of times the mass of the Sun. If we could determine many of these first black holes, it would revolutionize our understanding of the early stages of the universe.